October 30th, the day Hurricane Tomas whipped through St. Lucia. Ahead of the first anniversary, NEMO is again warning residents to watch how they build their homes. A lesson the director of NEMO says residents should consider seriously.
We do build on stilts in this country, but then over time we tend to put an apartment downstairs, which is understandable. But in light of the flooding that we have seen with the flash floods in Denry, even before Hurricane Tomas, and then with Hurricane Tomas showing us landslide prone areas and flooding areas, these are some of the simple things we need to look at. Some of the lessons are hard, some of the lessons may be expensive, but we need to look strategically at ourselves.
Hurricane Tomas caused severe damage to the island's infrastructure last year. Ms. French says no one knows when a disaster will strike. However, residents should take precaution and always be prepared.
That does not mean that we must not continue to think about how we prepare ourselves, not just for storms. We've seen we can have earthquakes. The Caribbean is seismically active. We've got volcanoes in Martinique, we've got in St. Vincent, we've got in St. Lucia. So there are things that we need to bear in mind. We're talking about the anniversary of Hurricane Tomas, so we speak in flood and landslide. There's conversations you can have with your engineer, but there are things that we need to take on board individually, even as we look at government to take on its own mandate.
The Atlantic hurricane season comes to an official end on November 30th. Reporting for the DBS News World, I am Cecil Actil.